Hey church, so I want to read to you from Daniel 6. Now, when we look at the scripture here that we find, there were some people that were opposed to Daniel and his position, and they knew him, and they knew about his life. So I'm going to read something, and then we're going to talk about this a little bit. So, but when Daniel learned that the law had been signed, he went home and knelt down as usual in his upstairs room with its windows open toward Jerusalem. He prayed three times a day, just as he had always done, giving thanks to his God. Then the officials went together to Daniel's house and found him praying and asking for God's help. So the law that we know was passed, and they had done it targeting him, was he was not supposed to pray, bow down, or talk to any other god than the king. And so they had created this law for the purpose of catching Daniel because they knew about his life. So as I look at this section of scripture and as we look at the devotional for today, I pray that, you know, we would understand how consistent we need to be in our walk with God, our spiritual disciplines and what they mean, and that people around us should know the diligence, the consistency, and the way that we serve God, that we are devoted to Him above all else. And it doesn't matter what else happens in life. We are committed to our God. We're going to serve Him, and we're going to do what He says. No matter what laws are passed, no matter what happens going on around us, He is number one in our life. And so I love this about Daniel. It didn't matter what the laws of the land were. If they were contrary to his faith in God, he would stay faithful to his faith in God. I want to encourage you today. We have such amazing freedoms in our nation. We need to take advantage of it. But the point is that we would be so consistent in our walk that the people around us would know about our commitment to our God. Love you. Let's be his church.